Hello guys, good day! I'm back again for another tutorial regarding the Magnusbilling on how to add, how to point the domain and configure the SSL for our Magnusbilling or VoIP switch application. So, once again, before you continue watching of my video, please like and share, subscribe, and click the notification bell so that you're always updated on our latest video. Okay guys, so let's start the installation. For now, we have here our previously installed the Magnusbilling. So as you can see, we are using an IP right now. So we will now point this IP to our domain. So I'm using, actually my domain is from prenoms, but I configure the DNS to route 53 on AWS so that all the control for the domain is on my side. Okay, so let's check now and watch. Okay, so first you need to create open your domain, and then you can create the record. Okay, and then from here you can put Magnus. And then the IP address for the value, so that the domain it will point to your Magnusbilling server. Okay, so Magnus will be your switch subdomain, and then create the record. And then you need to wait a few minutes, or sometimes it will propagate within 24 hours before it take effect, but let's we need to wait and see if the domain is already working or running. Okay, so while you are waiting, you need to configure your, just go to your footy, access your Magnusbilling server on footy. So from here we will set up our host and settings. So, use the sudo. Add your Magnusbilling domain. So, and also you can add your local IP. And also your public IP. So after that we need to save this one, control 0, then press enter to save, control X to exit, and then go to the host name, control 0, then enter to save, control X to exit. Okay, and then you need to go to your Apache site available. You can configure the default host. Can add here server name, and then your domain name. So that's all for now. And then the report ssl.com. You can add also your server name. Okay. That's it. And then you need to restart your Apache service. Or you can also check, always run this config Apache 2 control config test. So once the syntax of it means your configuration and settings you modified, when your Apache.com settings and other settings has been as correct, so that once when you restart your Apache, we will not see any error on your server. Okay, and then still not yet working. So while we are waiting for the propagation or propagating for on the domain, so we will now configure or install our SSL. So just update sudo update first. And then we're gonna do sudo app install. So we will use certcode for now because I don't have a commercial SSL. But you can use commercial SSL, you can get to other SSL provider. If I do the search bot Apache, or we can do using the cert bot. First, so cert bot. Cert insert only. So you need to agree on the terms of condition. It will be, if you want certain to work, check. So okay, so this one directory web temporary standalone, so you can press 2 if you want and put your email address. Then you need to select 8 to agree. And then if you want to receive some news from Let's Encrypt, so you can type yes and for no. And then enter your domain name. So we will, okay. And then input the webhook. It is the web root, so you need to put your directory file for your web directory, and then you need to wait for the verification. But I don't see it will not work for now because I need to open the board. As you can see, failed to procedure error 705, so it's timeout. They have a timeout because the server is locked only on my security group. So I need to so from here, so I need to allow the so I need to add. So as you can see, we are able to generate our SSL. So, you can renew using the server renew. So now for now we need to check our we need to enable to 8-10 mode SSL. Okay, and then HTTP. HTTP 2 and the right. Okay, and then we need to check again config patch to control config test. So it means this it show its syntax. Okay, it means all the configuration we modified, no issue. Okay, so we need to service Apache 2 restart. So from here, so the domain is not yet running, maybe they have some issue and propagating. So the pictures are around 53. I think I miss, maybe I missed some configuration here. So that route 53 is not yet. Okay, that now it's so if I put HTTPS, okay, so let's check our A2 insight. So it means you need to enable your configuration. I guess I need to report processor. So as you can see, the domain or it's using an internal certificate 1, and now we need to configure the so that we can paste the SSL file to our default site. Okay, so you need to go to /etc. Apache site available and then default to ssl.com. So from here you need to modify these two files. So you need to I just commented and then I will add the other file, SSL file and the key file. So we're going to modify the file, so using the correct SSL we generated from Let's Encrypt. So the file location it will be on it's Let's Encrypt Live Magnus, and then this is your cert file, the full chain. So you will paste on here. You need to paste the path, the correct path for the SSL. And then for the key file, so the PEM private key, start in page, and then control 0 to save. Okay, and then if you need to change some setting, you can go down, control 0 to save, control X to exit. So then you need to check again, so just check if your modification it's correct. So Apache control config test before you do the restart. So if the syntax is okay, you can now save to restart the Apache service. Apache to restart or reload, it's okay. So much better you do the restart. So just start here in my screen. So when you refresh your page, you can see here is you have now already a valid SSL 1. So as you can see still, but if you use other nothing for the browser, so you will have successfully installed your valid SSL certificate, good for 3 months, so you can renew it before 1 month using the SSL. Okay, so from here, if you want to do the redirect, automatically all the requests it will be redirected to HTTP. For example, this one is using HTTP, HTTP only. So if you want to do the direct redirection, all the requests to HTTPS, so we will make a redirection request on our can add. So we can add, you need to go to your Apache configuration again, site available, and your default BIOS. So from here, you can add here, T4, I think you can also add from here. So get any logs. So we can put a redirection to your HTTP. Okay, so that all the requests will be redirected to HTTPS automatically. Okay, so when I refresh the page, it will redirected me to HTTPS. Okay, as you can see, automatically redirected. So let's see a sample again. So if I use the incognito, then I type only HTTP, and then I paste magnusbilling.tk. As you can see, it will redirected me to HTTPS. Okay, and now I will try to enable the HTTP2. So if you want to enable the HTTP2, you need to add the HTTP2 configuration protocol at the Apache tool site available, and then default.ssl.com. So from here, you can add the HTTP protocol. You can add the HTTP protocol. Okay, maybe you can add HTTP protocol, HTTP H2, so I control 0 to save, then exit, and then config press, and OK, then Apache restart. Okay, then if you refresh the page, still, so let's check our HTTP2. Let's check if we have on HTTP configuration. Let's copy my domain and paste here. So you need the HTTP is not yet supported on PK, so going to enable some settings so that the HTTP2 configuration file it will support on our settings. Okay, maybe I did not enable, so P2 and mode. You need to change some configuration settings on the Apache.com. Enable the HTTP2. So guys, as you can see, we have successfully installed the Magnusbilling with valid Let's Encrypt certificate. So for now, we're gonna set up the HDTV to maybe it's not compatible on the Debian, but we can find a solution soon. So for now, as you can see, we are now on HTTP, okay, so HTTPS. So that's all for now, guys. We have successfully installed our domain and configure it with SSL certificate using certbot or Let's Encrypt. So if you have a commercial one, you just need only to generate an open or CRS on your server, and then copy the CRS file and then paste to your SSL provider or website, so that you can generate and request your SSL certificate and download the certificate bundle cert and paste to your path on your server and configure your HTTP BOS so that your domain it will be authenticated with a secured HTTPS connection. So once again, guys, this is HBT tutorial. So don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and click the notification bell so that you always updated on our latest video. Okay, guys, thank you and have a nice day.